We are taking a look at the Sony Ericsson Xperia Play. After a lot of denials and wait and speculations, we finally saw that Sony Ericsson came out with a PlayStation phone. So this thing runs Android 2.3 at the moment, and we have been reviewing it for some time. While you would see the final review go up on Only Gizmos shortly, here's a quick video tour of the phone. So you can see it's a thick phone, somewhat bulky at 175 grams weight, but hey, it's kind of a portable PlayStation in your hand. So let's first have a look at all the controls and buttons on the device. Well, there are plenty of them. So you have the power button on the top. This side you have the micro USB slot and a 3.5 mm audio jack. So that's the portion which slides down. You have two gaming buttons over here, left and right. PlayStation portable users would be familiar with these, and the volume toggle. So that's one button with two different edges for up and down. You really don't have any ports on the bottom, and on the back you have the 5 megapixel camera and LED flash. So let's jump into the device. Okay, before that, let's have a look at the attraction of this device. So you have plenty of controls over here. You have select, start, you have a menu button here, and you'd see this D-pad over here, and the forward direction, the directional pad actually, and you have the touch sensitive controls over here as well. So you may use a combination of these or either of these to play a game depending on how it is designed. We will have a look at a FIFA game later on to see how it really works. For now, the Timescape UI on the Xperia Play, this is something which is Sony Ericsson's creation, and it works pretty well. Lags at times, I hope you did notice that little lag. So it's not the finest experience, but one thing we love about Timescape UI on the home screen is this. So instead of just lining up all the pages together, what Sony Ericsson has done is it puts all the widgets together in a miniature form on the single screen, and you can just jump into whichever you want. So that's a nice tweak. We would like a lot many manufacturers do this with their UI, but clearly the Timescape UI has some work to do, and we have started to believe after seeing a lot of different UIs on Android that if you want a social media integration in your UI, it's okay for normal users, but if you're a power user doing a lot of Facebook or Twitter, you certainly need a dedicated app. So the UI can help you just take a quick look at the clock, calendar, or your emails, but dedicated apps would never really phase out. So we still wait for a killer UI on Android to show up. Till then, let's jump into this. And there's one thing we do want to highlight over here, that Sony Ericsson has always on its Android phones, the Xperia series, it has had its own camera apps over here. Surprisingly, they are using the stock Android camera app. So that's probably because they aren't really focusing on the camera here. It's a very basic 5 megapixel camera. We would have the results soon, but it doesn't even do HD videos. So Sony Ericsson hasn't paid much attention to the camera for sure. That's one thing. So we do miss the official update to the camera app which Sony Ericsson normally has. It enhances the photo quality as well. So jumping in, let's start with a game. We'll have a look at FIFA. It comes pre-bundled, and here are the controls. To be honest, I am not a football person, but I'll try my best to show you the controls. Classic. Begin. Start match. You can see the controls being showed over here. The L is, I believe, over here, back here. Attacking, hold L plus the box. Okay, so let's see. Okay, so we had a noise disturbance, so I would start with this again. So now I'm trying to use the touch panel over here to navigate the player, and I can tell you it's not easy to use it. Moving from physical buttons to something like this isn't easy. Though we do hate a complete touchscreen control, we think this can be improved upon. So, yeah, you certainly can make out that I am not the best person to play this game, but I'm trying to make the best of the controls, and I believe it will be a fair amount of time before you get used to this touchpad over here. Okay, so I'm not gonna really take much of your time playing the game. Just to give you a fair idea of how the controls work, I believe PlayStation users might find this good, just with a small note that the touch sensitivity would take some time to get used to. Another interesting thing I just noticed over here, that WhatsApp comes pre-installed by Sony Ericsson here, so clearly an attempt to counter the BBM hype. And at the same time, yep, I believe this will be it for our Xperia Play review. Thank you.